How can we possibly work out this question with Pythagoras' theorem with only one solitary piece of information? Got to think about this. Well, maybe there's a clue in the question, because if you look at the clues in the question, then maybe you can do this question. So let's first start off by writing up Pythagoras' equation, because that's going to give us a lot of clues. So let's do that first. So we know it's a squared plus b squared equals c squared. Okay, that's our equation. Now, looking at this square, and we know it is a square, our target and our mission is to work out this length here, AB. Now, generally, if we can work out AB, we can kind of work out the other lengths because it is stated in the question that it is a square, which means we can actually label this and say, well, let's just call AB, the length up there, let's just call it X. So I'll put that X. And wouldn't you agree that if that's an X along there, this here would also be an X, wouldn't it, since it's a square? So let's put that there. So the length AD, also an X. Okay, we have two X's there. Now remembering, we only have one piece of information. We've got to come up with two. So there's our equation. So we've started off the question well, because we've got our equation, we've labeled our diagram. Now we can take the next step. Let's just continue from here. Well, if we got the two X's here, well, that length and that length is connected to the right angle, so clearly they're not hypotenuse, are they? The hypotenuse is right here, the 18. So maybe we can put the hypotenuse, the 18, in first now. So that's going to be C, isn't it? So let's go 18 here squared. That's there, right here, right there. That's the C, the hypotenuse. Okay, cool. Now, this is the awesome part. We have A squared plus B squared. Now, that would be this length and that length, because they're at right angles. So let's put that in. So let's put in x squared plus x squared. There are the two x squareds. One is here, the other one is there. Okay, let's go to solve this. And the first place we'd want to do is add up the two x's. Now x squared plus x squared, being pronumerals, is kind of easy. We can add them together and turn them into 2x squared. So that'll be 2x squared equals, now we have 18 squared. You put that in your calculator. I'm just going to check. It's actually 324. Now, we have an equation here. That's because we have the equals inside. Let's divide both sides by 2. That way we can get rid of the 2 and leave it with the x. Let's do that. So we divide by 2. And what we do to this side, we also do to the other side, divide by 2. Okay, 2 divided by 2, we can simply just cancel that, can't we? So that cancels, that cancels. So we're left with a grand total of just x squared by itself. So let's bring down the x squared, and that equals 324 divided by 2 is 162. Okay, let's do square root both sides. That'll be a good idea, so let's do that. So we square root that side, and we also square root that side. Now, the square root of x squared is simply x. It reverts back to x equals the square root of 162 is 12 point. Now, this is the length here, right? That's the x there we're looking for, which is the same as that x there. X equals 12.73 centimeters. Always remember the units.
Take a minute to check out our website at http://www.vividmaths.com. You'll find additional resources, cheat sheets, transcripts, and other maths videos that are not available on YouTube. Lastly, don't forget to subscribe to get access to all the written answers for your maths questions, plus other special offers.